He is called Mr. 3% for allegedly skimming that amount off the top of every construction job in Montreal. Former municipal fundraiser Bernard Trepanier is on his second day of testimony in front of the Charbonneau Commission. He denies the allegations that he pocketed hundreds of thousands of dollars, and he says anyone who accuses him of stealing is flat out lying. Catherine Cullen's been tracking these proceedings. So, Catherine, what has happened so far?
It has been a fascinating morning, Rashmi, and let's start with that famous or infamous 3%. Bernard Trepanier was asked flat out. Witness after witness has told us that you were collecting this 3% kickback. What do you say to that? It's impossible, it's impossible, it's impossible. He repeated it three times, said it was simply not the case. He was asked about each individual allegation made by various witnesses before the Charbonneau Commission, that he asked them for cash, sometimes $100,000, sometimes $200,000 to contribute to the Union Montreal Municipal Party, the party of the mayor at the time. Bernard Trepanier says simply that the stories aren't true. And in fact, with one particular witness, he flat out called the man a liar. But just in the last few minutes or so, things have taken quite a change, quite a twist here at the Charbonneau Commission. Trepanier has admitted that, yes, there was a system going on where contracts were being doled out, a sort of sharing of contracts. He says it was already in place when he came to Union Montreal in 2004. But he says in 2005, something changed, that he was called to a meeting with two senior executives at engineering firms in Laval, just north of Montreal, that they had seemed to have had a fair bit to drink. They sat him down and they said, Bernard, the system of sharing isn't working. You're not doing a very good job. You're not to be involved in this anymore. Don't ask any questions. Don't ask who's behind this. Stay out of it. Now, Bernard Trepanier says he did consider that to be a threat. As for why he was ever involved in this system in the first place, something that he's been asked several times about by the lawyer, he's essentially saying that he really doesn't know. The system was there, doesn't know why he should have been involved in it, and he doesn't really know exactly why it was taken away from him either.
Okay, so there were more questions today, too, about Trepanier's work, right, for various companies as a so-called consultant?
Exactly. It's quite a complex picture we have here. But so on the one hand, he's doing this job as a fundraiser for the then mayor's political party. At the same time, he has this company called Baremax. It's a consulting company, Bernard to the Max. That's where the name came from, we learned yesterday. And he's getting these contracts for tens of thousands of dollars with engineering firms. And what are these contracts for? Well, we spent a lot of the morning trying to figure that out. Trepanier had all sorts of interesting stories. For in one instance, he said that he was paid tens of thousands of dollars for helping somebody within an engineering firm stop drinking. Trepanier himself had given up alcohol several years ago. In another case, he's paid tens of thousands of dollars, he says, for going and overseeing renovations at a condo in Miami. So some very surprising stories. He also says he's a man who opened doors, but really we never seem to entirely understand exactly what he did with this consulting firm.